Have you ever wondered how much damage there needs to be to a PVC insulated cable for the insulation resistance to come down from that large value of 999 megohms, for example? Today we're going to find out. So let's turn the meter to 500 volts DC and carry out the insulation resistance test on a nice healthy circuit. Line to neutral, bigger than 999 megohms. Neutral to CPC, bigger than 999 megohms. Line to CPC, bigger than 999 megohms. We're now going to cause some damage to this PVC insulated cable. Let's see how much damage there needs to be for those values to start decreasing. As you can see, quite a lot of damage there. So I've broke through the sheath, the grey sheath of the twin cable. Let's do that test again. Line to neutral, bigger than 999 megohms. Neutral to CPC, 999 megohms. And finally, line to CPC, bigger than 999 megohms. So quite a lot of damage there to the actual PVC insulated cable, but the resistance itself is still very, very high. Let's cause some more damage. As you can see, the cable is really damaged, but the insulation resistance still remains high. Let's cause some damage using a screw. And there we have it, the first time we've got that reading of a short circuit. So in the end, we've had to cause a lot of damage to that cable to get those insulation resistance values down. So this shows the importance of the inspection process throughout an installation. The IR test is not always going to pick up damaged cables, floorboards, pressing on cables, etc. This is all part of the inspection process throughout the install, as well as the testing at the end.